All right, how about a little bit of grade 12 statistics? This is grade 12 essential and grade 12 applied. So statistics, and I thought I'd look at number 6 Canadian bomber group in World War II. So we had like 16,000 Canadians in the Air Force flying bombers in World War II. The old famous Lancaster, for those who are familiar. Let's do some statistics and, let's do some stats. So you'll find, well, this is actually grade 12 essential as well. It's also grade 12 applied. So I'm going to give you some selected data from the Commonwealth War Graves Commission. So everybody who died for Her Majesty or for the Crown, there's a list of everybody's names on a website if you ever want to see them. There's millions of them, millions of names. Anyway, I went through and I selected 30 names that were in the Air Force. And I just took 30 Smiths, all right, and I wrote them down. And I checked out what their age is. So we'll check out how old they were when they died, their average age, their median age, the most popular age to die, the most common age. Then we'll look at the range of how old guys were that died. We didn't let women fly back in those days. So number 6 bomber group was about 15,000 air people. I think it was all guys. 9,919 of them died. That's a pretty big number. Later on in probability, you'll learn that you only had like a 35% chance of living if you were doing that job. But a good way to go. All right, so here's the numbers we'll come up with. And we'll look at all the data, but here's the numbers we'll come up with. Not sure why they're coming in backwards. When we calculate the mean age, the average age, we'll find out it's 23.77, under 24. We'll find out the median age is 23 years. In other words, half of your flyers were 23 and above, and half of your flyers were 23 and below. We'll find out the most popular age to die. Well, the most common age to die was 22 years old. And we'll find that the range of all the flyers was a whopping 9 years, right? It went from like age 20 to 29. There was no 30-year-olds that died. Well, not of the ones that I selected. So like I said, I went through the Commonwealth War Graves website, and I just checked out the name Smith, and I picked the first 30 Smiths. And there was lots of Smiths. This is just the first 30. So if I take 30, that should probably represent pretty close to what happened to 9,000 of them. All right, so like, for example, the first guy was Smith, Albert. His name was Albert Smith. He was a flying officer, so he was probably one of the pilots or a navigator. His service number was Juliet Diagonal 15771. He died or was shot down. On the 13th of June, 1943, he was 23 years old. Everybody I checked out was in the Royal Canadian Air Force, of course. He was a Canadian. There's where he's buried. You can even go visit his grave, and that's the cemeteries, and I think that's in Belgium. All right. The second guy was Alfred Smith. He was a pilot officer. His service number was Juliet Diagonal 862-99. He was shot down and killed on the 27th of January, 1944. He was 23-year-old as well, and he was Royal Canadian Air Force. And there's his grave, position 5, Delta 24, and he's buried in Berlin, so he was probably shot down right over Berlin. And on and on and on, there's just 30 of the guys that I randomly picked. And here's a few more, right? There's Armand and Arthur and another Arthur and Corey Smith and Bert Smith and Benny Smith and all kinds. And here's where they were buried. And you can kind of tell what job they had from their rank. Usually your sergeants were your gunners, the guys that shot the guns. They didn't usually have a very long lifespan. In the Lancaster, once one of the enemy 109s rolled in on you, you had about 6 seconds to live. But That's what they did. Alright, notice this guy here is actually buried in Winnipeg. Alright, so Dave Smith, air craftsman, first class. His service number was Romeo Diagonal 56916. He was shot down on March 15, 1941. Oh, he was an old guy. He was 25. And you can actually go visit him in Brookside Cemetery, right at the end of Notre Dame in Brookside there, right by the Red River College. I've been there. I went and said hi to Dave and said, thanks a lot, Dave. Anyway, you might want to visit the Brookside Cemetery. It's the biggest cemetery in Canada. It's one of the biggest in the world for military people. Anyway, so here's how the battle unfolded. Of course, there was a war from 39 to 45. Here was England. Here was Germany. Of course, France is over here. So our Canadians were living right here. They were based up here in Yorkshire. And they would fly over to Germany and drop bombs. And sometimes they'd fly in a formation of 1,000 bombers. And all you had to do was fly for 30 missions, and you went home. Unfortunately, it's not likely you'll live for 30 missions, but hey. So what age was our Air Force guys? What old were they when they died in World War II? Geez, in one night, you know, one night they did a huge raid. They took off 1,000 of these bombers, and they actually killed 300,000 people in one night. And this wasn't just military people, right? This was the town of Dresden. It could have been more. So one night they actually dropped bombs and killed 300,000 people in one night. Not very sporting, that. We don't do that anymore. So there was the famous Lancaster. That's what Canadians flew. And of course, yeah, the bad guy was this guy up here, the ME-109, the Messerschmitt 109. Those guys were pretty good at shooting these guys down. That's why these like to go in a pack of dozens and hundreds and even 1,000 sometimes. That way they could bring more. Look at the gun there, and the gun there, and there was a gun there. Oh, there's guns all over this. There's a gun underneath in the belly. All right? So this guy here didn't live long. Whoever worked in that job didn't live very long, because he was the first guy that these guys would shoot. Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to fill out that template. We're going to calculate their ages. So we're going to write down all the data like that. Alright, there was the different ages. And went all the way from 20 to 29 in my sample. And then we count how many times we had that age. So we had one 20-year-old. We had three 21-year-olds. Oh, look, there was nine 22-year-olds that died, at least in my data. I didn't sample all 9,000. I just looked at 30 of them. And there was three 24-year-olds and three 25-year-olds. All right, so there's all the numbers. Notice when you add them up, sometimes you don't count right and you gotta fix them up. As long as it all adds up to 30 at the end, that's a pretty good clue that you didn't miss anybody. Oh, see, mine added up to 29 because I had missed somebody. All right, so you just make sure you didn't miss anybody. That's called a checksum. Then we'll do this accumulated column. We'll add them up. So 1 plus 3 is 4. And this way it just helps you find the median. You'll see that in a second. 4 plus 9 is 13. 13 plus 3 is 16. So this will be a running total, an accumulated running total here. All right, so we'll run this running total. We'll need that later to calculate the median. All right, so just fill up this table. If you always kept this with you, you'd be able to do statistics real easily. All right, so I hope you know that 120 is 20. And then we had three 21-year-olds, so that'd be a 21 and a 21 and a 21. Those three 21s would add up to 63. And we had nine 22-year-olds, so that'd be a 22 and 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 a 22. So that'd be 198 when we added up those nine guys. And then you get this 69, and then you get this 72, and then you probably got a 70. Let's just fill in all these numbers. You fill in this template. Right? This template helps you calculate all this stuff. Unless you felt like adding up all those ages. But if you do it this way, it's less adding to do. Right? You've only got like, how many? You got 10 numbers to add up there instead of 30. So when we total all that up, you end up with 713. And, you know, that's the sum of all 30 guys, and it comes to 713 divided by 30, and you'll be able to calculate the mean or average age was 23.77. So the average age of the guys that died in number 6 bomber group flying bombing missions was 23.77. Years. And, oh, look, the mode. The mode is the most popular age. The most popular age to die, I guess the most common age to die, was there was 9 people that died at age 22. So that was the most common age to die. So the mode is the number that is the most common. So it's 22. It's not 9. It's 22. And let's calculate the median. So if you've got 30 people, right, if you got 30 people, you want to find the 15th person, because the 15th person would be halfway up. Well, actually, you want the 15 and a half person. All right. So let's find the 15th person. Well, this is a running total of everybody. So there's the first person. There's the first 4 people. There's the first 13 people. So here's the first 16 people are here. So the 15th person must have been in this group here, the 23 range. So that would be called your median, or X squiggle. So your median age means half of your people were over 23 and half of your people were under 23. So the median, just like the median on the highway, is the halfway place. Notice the numbers are all pretty close. That's kind of normal for most distributions. Alright, so the most common age to die was 22. The average or the mean was 23.77, close to 24. And the median, the halfway age, was 23. Often they're pretty close. And if you graph them, they'll look like that. All right, there was our tally chart, our frequency table. And if you graph all this stuff, because a picture's worth 1,000 words, if you graph it, it looks like this. All right, so like we said, we did the math there and we found out the average age to die was 23.77. And it turns out the median age to die, in other words, half of the people were older and half of the people were younger, was 23. And the most popular, well, I should say the most common age to die was 22. And you can kind of see this from this histogram, eh? Right? This is called a histogram. It's a graph of all those numbers there. All right. Notice it's a little bit skewed here. There was an awful lot of 22-year-olds that died. Maybe it's just the sample that I chose just happened by accident to have a lot of 22-year-olds. Maybe it's more shaped like this if I'd have sampled more people. But now we're talking pretty advanced stuff about, you know, how many people should you sample to get an accurate statistic. That looks a little bit unusual to have that many, have it sticking out that high. But that's what the statistics said for my 30 people. And there's a graph of how old you were when you died, or at least how old those 30 people were when you died in the Air Force. Anyway, it's all just part of being in the Air Force. I used to be on the Hercules. We had 31 of them. We crashed 8. So what's 8 divided by 31? 8 divided by 31. That's 26%. So 26% of the guys I worked with kind of died. There's the Hercules. And, of course, when you're in the military, you always have some fancy sayings. Right? That others may live. That's what we used to say when we did search and rescue. So if you died saving people, that was good. And sometimes you said truth, duty, Valerie. Although sometimes we'd call it Ruth, Trudy, and Valerie. I guess. All right. And sometimes you'd say, we carry the load, onus portamus. Or sometimes you'd say, we're determined to deliver. Right? That's certi prevendi. That's Latin for determined to deliver. Or you could sing a song about through adversity we'll conquer. Blaze into the sky, a trail of glory. We'll live on land and sea till victory is won, etc. Such is the path to the stars. All kinds of fun things you can say in Latin. A trail of glory. Anyway, that's what the Air Force does for you. Go check out the cemetery and say hi to a couple folks there. They might like it, you know. Briefing is complete.